Now that we know a little bit more around joins, let's try to update our query to solve this original question. We want to show each photo URL, even if there is not a user associated with them. Right now, with the very simple join that we have, we are doing by default an inner join. So we will only see rows where we have a solid match between a photo and a user. That's not quite what we want. We want to make sure, as we see here with the left outer join, that even if we have some photo that is not matched up to a user, we should see it inside of our output result set. So to do so, all we have to do is convert our inner join into a left outer join. To go from an inner join to a left outer join, all we have to do is put on that keyword left right there. That's it, nothing else. Okay, so back over here, I'm gonna put on left join. We'll then run this. And then if we scroll all the way to the bottom of our result set, we'll see down here banner.jpg and the associated username is null. So we are seeing banner.jpg here because we are now doing a left join, which will include all rows from photos, even if there is not a matching user. Whenever we try to list out properties from the associated user with this image or this photo, we'll just see values of null. Okay, so that's a left outer join. Let's now try out a right outer join. So an example of a right outer join would be if we try to do something like list all users and their associated photos, and even list users who do not have a photo. Let's try to add in a brand new user to our users table, and this user will probably have no photos associated with them. We'll then try to do a right outer join, and you're going to see that even though this brand new user does not have any photos, we will still see them listed. Okay, I'm going to first delete this query, and we'll add in a little bit here to add in a brand new user. We'll do an insert into users. We're going to specify only a username. We'll provide values of just Nicole. That's going to be our new username. So I'm going to run this. Looks like it was successful. And now we can do another join where we try to pull out the URL and the username. And we want to make sure that we select not only our photos, but every single user. So we'll do a select URL and username from photos. We will do a write join on users. I'll put in that on keyword, and then we will give our matching criteria. So we want to match up rows from users with rows from photos using the criteria users.id equals to photos.user_ID. Okay, so let's now run this. Now we're going to see a very similar output to what we saw before, where we see all of our different usernames with the associated photo URLs. But if we scroll all the way down to the bottom, we'll now see that we've got a user here with no photos associated with them at all. We've got Nicole, and the associated photo is null, or really the URL is null, because there is not a photo associated with Nicole at all. Okay, so that's a right outer join. And now finally, we'll take a look at a full join. So again, this is going to give us all of our different results, all the different rows in both tables, even if they do not actually match up. So at this point, we have banner.jpg with no matching person, and it's now really Nicole with no matching photo. So to do a full join, just one small change, change that keyword right there from right to full. We'll then run this, and now we'll see, okay, get all the same results. And if we scroll down to the bottom, here's Nicole, they have no matching photo, and here's a photo with no matching user. So a full join will give us all results, even if they don't match up on either side. All right, so that's just a couple of examples around each of these different kinds of joins. Now there are some more notes I want to give you around this stuff, so quick pause, and I'll talk to you in just a little bit for just a couple more things around these joins.